Got it. Did the Minutemen send you?
Yes, I'm here to help. What's the problem?
There's a group of raiders that won't leave us alone. Stealing our food and supplies and threatening us if we can't give them what they want. We know where they're coming from, but we can't stand up to them ourselves.
Any idea how many raiders we're talking about?
No telling, I'm afraid. This time there were three, but who knows how many are back at their base.
Thank you. Stop playing around, Danny. I'm standing out in the open here for crying out loud.
I got orders not to let you in, Miss Piper. I'm sorry. I'm just doing my job.
Ooh, just doing your job. Protecting Diamond City means keeping me out, is that it? Oh, look, it's the scary reporter.
I'm sorry, but Mayor McDonough's really steamed, Piper. Saying that article you wrote was all lies. The whole city's in a tizzy.
You open this gate right now, Danny Sullivan. I live here. You can't just lock me out. You. You want into Diamond City, right?
What? Who are you?
Shh. Lay along. What's that? You said you're a traitor up from Quincy? You have enough... You hear that, Danny? You gonna open the gate and let us in, or are you gonna be the one talking to crazy Myrna about losing out on all the supply?
Jeez, all right. I need to make it personal, Piper. Give me a minute.
Better head inside quick before old Danny catches on to the bluff.
Sounds good. Let's go.
Another great day in Diamond City.
Piper, who let you back inside? I told Sullivan to keep that gate shut. You devious, rabble-rousing...
Favorite puts on quite a show, huh?
Pastor.
Some show, right?
What do you mean by that?
Well, folks are already plenty scared. Anyway.
What's the Institute?
Ever heard of them?
Uh-huh.
But they're just a fact, at least inside. So what brings you?
Looking for someone who's
gone missing.
Right. Who would I talk to about finding...
I'm afraid.
Uh-huh.
And with all the fear of the
I'm lost, Pat.
Well, I don't want to get your hopes up, but there is someone, Nick Valentine.
Nick Valentine, huh? What's his?
You know the story.
Uh-huh.
Well, I
Mm-hmm. Thanks. I'll go talk to him.
Take care of yourself now.
Piper, you're back.
Hey, kiddo. How are the paper sales?
Well, the presses are getting overloaded. That motor is going to go soon if we don't replace it.
You've been saying that for weeks and the old girl still keeps cranking. Stop worrying so much. I gotta head into the office. You start whistling if you see any angry politicians coming our way.
Why? Is something wrong? Piper? Extra, extra! Is your neighbor really human? We have the exclusive!
We'll talk more once I get some money.
Hey, Piper.
Holding up, Blue?
Why are you calling me that?
Because you're a vault dweller?
Uh-huh.
So here's the deal. You do that?
Uh-huh. What kind of interest?
I ask you who you are. What do you say?
All right, Piper.
Good. So, I know you're from a vault. How would you describe...
My family and I were frozen.
Wait, they boxed you up in a fridge?
Yes, I'm over.
Oh my god. So, you've seen the Commonwealth, Diamond City.
Honestly, seeing every-
That's surprisingly inspired, Blue. Now, the big question.
I lost family.
What's their name, Blue?
My son, Sean.
The parent after the missing child. Tell me.
I don't know.
No one ever does. For the last part of our interview, I'd like to do something different. I want... The threat of kidnapping is all but ignored in the Commonwealth. What would you say to someone out there who's lost a loved one but might be too scared or too numb to the world?
Mm-hmm. No matter how much you want
to... A strong note to end on, Blue. That's everything. It's gonna take some time to put this all together, but I think your story is gonna give Diamond City plenty to talk about. Anyway, I agreed to come with you, right?
Piper.
Heading my way?
You sure you want to travel with me?
Well, it's that, or get back to writing.
Sure, let's go.
Will do. Oh, sorry, boy. Time.
Hey, boy. Come on, boy. It's time to go. Hey, sweetie.
Free paper to newcomers. It's the Institute.
The Institute?
You ain't heard of it. It's all in the...
Who's gone missing?
Drifters, residents, so you better...
I believe you.
You're a real lost lamb.
Hey.
You should really talk to the pastor.
If you're here to pray, sit down and be quiet.
Of his, her, and her perfect hair.
The mayor's secretary.
Hey,
that's
you're looking for a haircut.
It, Johnny, you wouldn't be able to tell the difference. You, Nick McDonough, with your razor, he'd don't mean nothing.
Do yourself a favor and just say yes.
Yes?
It's all.
Thank you.
all he understands.
There's a fire on the old theater.
I'll take a look, sure.
Excellent.
Everyone in this city is always jumping at shadows. Chill out, is what I say.
Hey, Solomon.
You gotta accept life on its terms, you know? Something bad happens, just say yes to it.
Your luck wouldn't last forever. His ties. Oh, Nick. The bills. Huh. Forget the bills. The photographs. He never did photograph well. Detective secretary. I'll never find another job.
Hmm.
Something wrong?
Another stray coming in from the rain. Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
I know you must be busy, but I won't take much of your time, miss. It's important.
You don't get it.
Don't worry, I can help.
There's an old vault down.
Hey, I'd love to help.
Don't play games with me.
I'll find him. You have my word.
Thank you. Nick should be easy to...
second is our faith and trust in each other. The faith and trust that has given us prosperity, security, and education for everyone.
Don't touch the paint.
And while the paper might point their fingers at sin.
What? Why?
This is the war. No. Thinking you need it.
What do you need done?
You see this paint I'm using? Only one place left in the whole hardware town. Rune store close by to the west.
Only if you throw in some more.
Fine. Pay you 125 caps.
I think you can do better.
Driving a hard bargain, huh? 150 caps.
Paint retrieval. I'm on it.
Much obliged.
Hi. There.
Travis.
Hey. I mean, hi. Again. Hi? Hi.
This little stand of yours.
Every drop of water that comes out of that filter is 100% pure. What is a legitimate business?
Officer?
Hey, you're in the paper, right?
By city
you're 200 years old.
Hey, Shang.
Your age,
I'm a busy man.
It's a health hazard, Shang.
Profit hazard is what I say. I manage the water, and I'll do it without your interference. Thank you very much.
Shang.
Can't talk now. Some other time.
Professor, I have a new theory about how the Institute makes the synths.
Oh no. We've been talking about this, remember? After last time.
Hi there.
Shouting.
Are you here for
sleeping on the cold floor of the lab for 3 nights?
Biology lesson?
That's right. Now, we all talk. You have
gamma rays?
That's right. Now, gamma rays, but some.
Uh-huh. What kinds of things have adapted?
Oh, that's the perfect
field trip?
That's right. You go. I usually have a.
Right. Sign me up.
You're gonna go out and find a bloat fly. Radioactive adapt.
Sure.
So what do you say?
I do a job.
This isn't about money.
Get the blowfly gland. Got it.
Remember, bring.
Hey, Dr. Duff.
Dissecting a bloatfly can be fun. Just avoid getting stung to death, and you'll be a junior scientist in no time.
Excuse me, Professor Scara?
Dr. Duff handles all the visitors. Bother her.
believe you eat that food.
Word is,
only one thing
something bad went down in the old museum of witchcraft up near Salem.
Yeah, it's gotta eat. What can I say?
A real Diamond City boy eats at a noodle stand.
Madame, I need to talk.
Just a minute, Yetim. I am in middle story.
So then, I am crossing river.
Wearing nothing but a smile, when out comes the most dangerous of all sea monsters, a Meyerlurk!
A Meyerlurk? Come on!
That's like 2 out of 10 points of danger tops. Now, if you want to talk something really deadly...
Vadim!
I forgot you were there, Yefim. What is it?
You know what? Never mind. I'll handle it myself. Oh, a customer. Need a room?
What's the story with this place?
Not much to say. My brother Vadim...
Uh-huh. Here's your caps.
You're in room 2, just through the door. Stay.
See this bar? I killed a man for it. No, I kid. He is dead, though. Now, let me know when you're ready to order.
So, this your bar?
Damn straight it is. My brother Yefim and I make... Mm-hmm. We call it Bobrov's Best. Had to start renting out rooms just...
Let's see what you have.
Don't order just...
Uh-huh. You read the paper.
Damn sense. Hiding among us.
Hi there. You can order drinks and food here or at the bar.
Who owns this bar, anyway?
The Bobrov brothers picked this place up a few years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Vadim...
Sure. Let's take...
Hopefully nothing will...
Pop. Uh-huh.
You there. We need to have a conversation.
Do I know you?
No. But I've heard of you. I'm always looking for people who know how to handle themselves in dangerous
situations. Uh-huh. I don't mind danger, so long as I get paid well enough.
You will be well paid. I can promise you that. By the way, I'm Edward Deegan. You'll mostly be working for me, but you'll need to talk to my boss first. His name is Jack Cabot. He likes to personally interview everyone I hire. He's careful like that. Come down to Cabot House in Beacon Hill and ask to talk to Jack. I'll let him know you're coming.
Hey there.
Hey. What's your story? Mercenary? Caravan guard?
Wrong on both tries.
I can usually spot. Anyway, I'm just kicking back and sharing stories while I'm between things. I've been all over, seen vaults, pre-war room.
You've been to a vault?
Yeah. Ever heard of Vault 81? They're standoffish, but every once in a while, they'll let new people in.
Mm-hmm. Let's hear your best monster story.
I'm from Diamond City. Don't go to University Point. Trust me, you don't want to know what they're kicking.
So you explore old ruins?
Last place I was going to check out was Salem. Real old town far to the north. Never made it.
See you around, Hawthorne.
Yeah, take it easy.
Just stop, okay? We got our own problems.
I'll take your order whenever you're ready.
Wake up, Commonwealth. Since they're not your enemy, they are victims in this war as well. True, they were created by the Institute, but they were created as slaves. Thinking, feeling, and dreaming beings, utterly oppressed by their tyrannical masters. So join with us in fighting the real enemy, the Institute. Join the Railroad. When you're ready for that next step, don't worry. We'll find you.
Got it.
Just don't throw up all over my floors.
Yourself out?
That's right. Now, how about...
Anything I can do to help? Depends. What's this?
Job's 100 caps. I like you. 125.
Come on. My time.
No. We're not...
I'm on it.
Just don't... The water is now. Good job. Here's your pay. Now, how about you pick up some bottles for the road?
Shang? Why was there a skull in the water?
So maybe you weren't the first person I asked. Maybe the last. Hey, once the filter.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, need some water?
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Bottle just today.
Thank you. Hey.
What can I get you?
Let's see what you have.
Hey, everyone's got...
Whatever you want, I ain't got time.
Don't move, synth. What have you done with the real Riley? Where's my brother?
I swear, I'm not a synth. Don't shoot, for God's sakes, we're family!
Put the gun down, now!
He's a synth! He'll kill us all!
Kyle, no!
Brothers are looking for you.
Okay, show's over. There are no synths in Diamond City, hear me? Just you folks and your damn paranoia.
Hey.
He pulled a gun on me. My own brother.
What happened?
I'm not a synth. I told him. I kept...
I need you to step away, Scabber.
I understand, officer.
You got bricks for ears? I said get the hell out of...
Doctor?
Oh, what a mess. Oh, what a mess.
Legitimate medical concern? Is this about our facial reconstructive services?
Facial reconstruction? What's that?
It's Doc Croft. Now, if you have an actual medical...
So what kind of treatments are...
Bandaging wounds and cleaning...
Yeah.
Go over your symptoms with me.
Too much radiation.
Blood pooling. Done. Now, was there anything else bothering you?
I've been laying off chems and booze lately.
Glad to hear it. Anything else?
Hurting all over, Doc.
Scrapes and bruises. But it's probably...
Right.
All done. Any other complaints?
Mm-hmm. No other complaints.
All right. Don't ruin my hard work by dying out there.
A new face. Strong, but not perfect. For a nominal fee, Doc Crocker can give you the looks you've only dreamed about before.
Wait, what are you gonna do to me?
I'm proposing surgery. Not just any surgery. Facial reconstruction surgery. New jawline. New eye.
I'll think about it.
Of course, of course.
got nothing better to do?
Hey, Nat.
Hey, mister. That interview you did with Piper is really selling. Here's your free copy.
Got plenty of ramen meat on the hooks.
Wait, what kind of meat is it?
You never heard of everything's fresh.
Sure. Weird stuff? Weirder?
Yeah, Prince Charming.
I'll take a look, sure.
Remember.
Quiet, you fool. All right, you. Tell me, Diamond City Radio is terrible, yes? Makes you want to cut your own ears off.
So, what's the issue?
Have you not listened? This DJ Travis, he's terrible. Makes me want to go back in time and prevent radio from ever being invented.
Vadim.
It's true. Don't listen to my brother. Someone needs to get rid of him. We need a new DJ for the radio. I don't think many would notice if he, you know, disappeared.
Are you serious?
Did we not just agree this is a serious problem? Calls for serious solution. First, you get him to follow you out of town.
All right. That's enough. Vadim isn't serious. He doesn't really want to kill Travis.
Okay, what's really going on here?
Sorry, we was just joking around a bit.
It's true. Only jokes. Travis is a good friend. Yefim and I...
Well, Travis, he means well, but he does not have the confidence he needs for that job. Or anything else, really. And so he's always awkward. He does not believe in himself, you see? He expects he will fail at everything, and so he does.
So, are you actually trying to do something about it?
I tell Yefim that I have plan. He does not believe me. You and I work on plan. Go on, spoil sport. Go back to working. We will figure out how to help Travis. Come, you. Meet me in back room. We discuss plan.
Yeah?
Everyone just buys the beer. But we have plenty of other drinks if you're feeling great.
Okay. Let us get down to brass tacks. I am glad you are willing to help. Unlike my deadbeat brother. Travis is a good guy. He deserves better life.
So, what did you have in mind? I'm gonna need some more in the way of details.
Ever been in bar fight?
What does that have to do with anything?
I ask because I want you to help Travis win his first bar fight. Think you can do that? I want to stage fight here in Dugout. Nothing too serious. We make sure Travis wins and feels good about himself. I want you to be there to help make it look real. What do you think? Sound good to you?
Gonna need some more information.
Okay. I have this all thought out. I have contacts. People I can count on. Real tough looking. But they will take a dive for money. They confront Travis here at Dugout. You step in and give him push he needs to stand up to them. Then you and Travis take them down. Nothing gets too rough. And Travis is something he can feel good about.
Uh-huh.
Simple, right?
If the goons are getting paid to fight, I want some too.
I am not made out of money. Yeah, it's too late today for me to arrange. You come back tomorrow evening after 6 o'clock and everything will be...
Have a nice day.
Hey, Yefim.
Just don't throw up all over my floors.
You'll notice there aren't any other ones. So...
Hey, Travis.
Don't break my stuff, if you don't mind. Okay. I usually don't. This is why.
Travis.
Don't break my stuff, if you don't mind.
Funny business.